Will, what are you most excited about the capabilities of the collection?
I'm really excited about just the camera on the, you know, using the iPhone as a dot of the brain for our camera and people using it like fashion. That's one thing I can't wait to go in the clubs and see people wearing it like this and say, hey, can I take a picture? And they're taking a picture with something that was in my head. And but then this being the first step to all the other things that we're gonna bring to market next year. And expanding this little nimble team we have to something a little bit more robust in the near future. And what I have in my brain for next year is pretty disruptive.
Yeah, I can work for that.
In a nice way. No disrespect.
Right. So the iPhone 5 one is coming soon. Yes. That's not launching now. Is that ready to play with? And sort of, is it ready? Why is it not launching at the same time?
The iPhone 5 was launched in September.
And that's coming in September.
Yeah. Well, no. What I'm saying is, iPhone 5 itself launched September. We are in November right now. It's just been 2 months.
Oh, I see.
And we're doing a breakthrough technology here. We are building a sensor into this. So it's going to take some time to get this product.
So it's still in development, really.
It is.
Not quite ready.
No, it is usable. It is ready. It's usable, and you're going to see it in stores. But we're just not going to release it until Q1 next year.
Okay. And second question. How unusual will that newer product be when it comes? Because I haven't seen anything quite like that one.
Say that again?
The iPhone 5 one, it does things differently. It circumvents the camera module, right? Is there anyone else doing products like that?
Not to our knowledge, yeah.
So the iPhone 5 would have a keyboard like this. Mm. It would have our own sensor. The flash. No, nobody does that.
Five times zoom.
It's pretty zoomy. And then, so we, like Chandra said, the iPhone 5 just came out in September.
Yeah.
So to make sure it's solid now. But January, it's even more solid. And it's just like a month away. But you could purchase it now at Selfridges for Christmas and then get it in January.
So it's up for pre-order now and coming in January, the iPhone 5 one.
That's right.
Yeah, really.
And what's the price on that one? It's not in the, is it in the thing?
We'll be announcing it in due course.
The price is unannounced, okay. Thanks.
Hi, you mentioned the next 20 years of your career will be in consumer technology. I'm just wondering if you're putting music on the back burner?
No, so if you think of, that's a good question. So music, it's always been synonymous with technology. It's just that we forgot about it. So you go up on stage and you hold that Grammy Award. That Grammy was a gramophone. It was the first iPhone, kind of. Because the company that owned Gramophone also owned the radio, which is RCA. So when you think of, and that was the first iTunes, really. But the difference was the music was for free only to sell lacquer. That was like your iPad or iPod, the vinyl. And your hardware played it. So now that that's all long gone, I'm still gonna make music, just that whose hardware am I selling? I would rather it be mine.
Roger Highfield from the Science Museum. Will, I was really blown away by the way that you're actually, rather than pontificating about technology, you're actually rolling up your sleeves and doing it. You mentioned you wanted to do coding next year. Can you tell me a bit about that? And do you fancy coming to the Science Museum to teach some of our 400,000 kids who come through each year a bit about the mysteries of coding? I'd love to get you in there.
Well, I don't know how I'll teach something I'm learning.
In a couple of years' time, obviously.
Yeah, yeah. I would. I'll sit with people like Chandra and Jared, and I'll just ran out all these ideas. And the translation of the ideas versus being able to do it, I want to just do it. You know, I just want to code and execute what's in my head. And maybe take 8 years. I'm still pretty young 8 years from now. So I want to start now.
You can come in 8 years' time if you want. That's fine.
You know what I mean? I remember when I was 16 years old, I told me and my friends who are now the P's, You know, when we were 16, I'm like, hey guys, maybe we should all pick up an instrument so that when we get older, we can really just do whatever we want to do with our ideas. And I was the only one that went to school to learn, you know, theory and the piano. I can't solo, but I could chord all day. And writing chords is like the basics of writing songs. Just see, you know. So I want to do the same thing for now coding. Right, it's 20 years later, 37 years old. By the time I'm 47 years old, I want to be the rockin'est, pro-est. I just want to be talking. I want to be able to sit there and just whiz away, you know? That's the reason why I want to discipline and dedicate myself to that. Because it's one thing to tell a kid to do that, and then you're off. I'm still going to go to clubs, right? It's one thing, like you in the club, and that's all you are in the club. That's it. I want to be in the club and in the classroom and applying as I try to encourage these kids to be involved in what's happening right now in the world.
Hi. I just wanted to ask about the price point. Obviously, you're aiming it at young people. Do you think that it's accessible enough, given that it costs nearly the same amount as a phone?
You know, the C4 is £199. And if you look at the iPhone accessory market as a general play, this is not an accessory, it's a product. It has interchangeable lenses, it makes your pictures better through those lenses. And the software that goes along with this is a professional tool that is made simple enough for consumers to use. So when you have all that intersection, the price package with that, when it turns your phone into something more than the phone itself, I think that's when the price is worth the value that you're getting. And that's what you get with the C-Force. And with the Vintage, it's £299 because it's a keyboard, it has the camera lenses. It's an intersection of multiple products coming together in a fashionable fashion.
That was good.
Let's go. More questions?
Hi, Will. You're obviously really interested in fashion. So the design and the style of the product, was that, how important was that when you were thinking about creating it?
So a lot of people in my industry, they put out clothes. And I've tried to dabble with that in the past. And I found clothing design, it's very hard. So to all the designers out there, you know, hats off for your skill and dedication and determination and making things and bringing them to market. Fashion is hard. And I didn't surrender at that. I just wanted to do fashion with technology. Because far too many of people that come from where I come from in music, they've done it and they've tainted anybody else that comes from music wanting to do clothes. It's just, for some reason, our community messed that up. It's like, soon as the artist says, hey, check it out, I'm doing clothes, it's like, you're gonna ruin it. And that's the truth, you know? Just the way that it's been done in the past. So I wanted to do fashion via technology. And the camera is one of the, you know, it's synonymous with fashion. So that's why I wanted to make it leather and gold and straps and technology that's wearable and carryable. So we have nice, you know, camera bags that will come Q1 next year, nice leather carrying cases for the camera. And I want to start there. So I've been talking to a great designer here from the UK about collaborating. Can't mention it yet, but you'll see that Q2.
And just to add to what Will just said, I mean, how important is design to him? If we were to put out all the designs that we did over the last 1 year, we would have a dozen products. I mean, that's how much we've reiterated this. We've iterated the product so much because of the value and the emphasis Will places on design. And he has a great sense of it.
You know, I just came from Brazil last week, and as we were coming on the airplane, it felt lonely, because usually when I'm traveling, there's like 20 people with me going to the airport with the peas, and now it's just me, Nick, and Nenad, and Enrique. it was kind of lonely when you're used to rolling with a herd. And so I was like, I had a vision. I'm like, I called Chandra, but Chandra was flying from Singapore to somewhere. And the vision was, I'm gonna tour products. I'm gonna go out and do performances and conferences around launching of products. I'm still gonna tour, I'm still gonna go out and do performances, but it's all gonna be around products. And that's the thing I'm really excited about, is to tour the world for a product and not for a consumer electronic product, IM Plus, and not this invisible, non-tangible thing that we tell you that you should buy. By the way, Scream and Shout is number one, two in America right now. So you should pick that up.
Congrats on the launch. It looks stylish, looks amazing. So I'm wondering, one, have you taken it around the world? Have you been living with this thing, trying it out? And also, have you shown it to all your friends? Has Cheryl seen it? Jesse J seen it? What do you think? Has it been everywhere?
So that's been the highlight of the past 8 months. Chris Brown will be in the studio in the front in LA, Record Plant. Sometimes Cheryl will be across. Rihanna will be down the street at another studio. And I'll be working with all the artists. And they're like, so, what new beat you got? I'm like, yo, check out this beat. So I play a beat. Right? And they'll be like, yo, that's funky fresh. I'm like, yeah, that's cool. Yo, did you see this camera? Check this stuff out, yo. And so they'll be like, what is that? I was like, yeah, you know what I'm talking about? Check this out. And so, when can I get that? I was like, oh, this is coming out for Christmas. Yo, I'm gonna be the first one for that. What other colors do they come with? You know, so to see my community just light up when I whip it out, it's not right.
Don't you guys write that.
To see, see my community, you know, excited about, you know, my passion point, it's been great.
Okay, there's a lady here.
Hi, you said you wanted to inspire young people to become the next Bill Gates, and women especially. There's been talk of doing that through a TV show. Would you do that on a show with Simon Cowell?
Why'd you have to throw that last part in?
But no, Simon, that's what's been rumored with doing it with him.
So I've been trying to do this for the past year and a half. We've been noodling with this concept. And I've executed, so this was an execution of how possible that is. So I needed to do this first before I, because one thing is to talk and there's no way to point to how to make it. So now that we've executed it, that TV show is the next, it's the next iteration for Q4 2013. That's, and the way things have been going, let me tell you this. And it was June of 2012. I go back home to my team. I'm like, look, I'm gonna do this. And they said, you're crazy. It's never gonna happen. There's no way you're gonna get into Christmas. It's June. I'm like, no, you don't. And when somebody says that, then for some reason, something in my mind goes, you're a salmon. You swim against stream and you freaking make it happen, right?
Absolutely, yeah.
And Chandra came and he was like, well, the team is being very difficult. And if you, almost got you.
He was like,
the team's being difficult, not difficult, they're being precautious, I understand. But if we don't buckle down, we're gonna be sitting here in November, very upset. So, and that was a great conversation that we had in August.
In June, yeah.
Yeah.
We have been having it on and off, but June was the main period.
Yeah, he was like, well, I'm telling you, if you believe in this, we have to do it ourselves because we can't wait around. And that type of, you know, tenacity and just like, power up. We powered up, and now we're here. So when I say Q4 2013 for this TV show, that's something now to power up, because we've executed the impossible. You know, we've done things where people were like, that's not going to happen. You're living in the clouds. That's not realistic. And now it's real. You know, I remember sitting with Selfridges, like, and then leaving that beautiful store and walking out with the biggest smile on my face, sitting in the car like, wow, this is really going to happen. And it is. And that TV show is really going to happen. Whoever it's with is whoever it's going to be with. You know? But it's going to happen. And I'm really excited about it.